gate is an 18 pounder.
Hey everybody, and welcome back to the garden. I have another issue here in my garden that I wanted to talk with you about today, and it is the squash vine borer. Now, if you start noticing your squash looking wilty, maybe yellowing out a little bit, look down here at the stem and you might actually see a little hole in it and a little bit of this orange stuff that looks like sawdust. That's called frass. If you have that, you're pretty sure that you have the squash vine borer. So today I'm going to let you know a few things you can do about it. And I'm going to do some surgery on my squash because I have nothing to lose. Obviously the plant is almost about to die. So let's see what we can do. First I'm going to put down a little towel where I can actually get down on it so I can see what I'm doing. And I have my really cool browning knife. It's pink and I love it. It's pretty sharp, so, and you'll want a sharp knife. So, let's get started. Okay, now I'm not sure where this little thing's gonna be. But you see the hole right there? He's made a hole right there. So, and I see a dark area right here. So I'm going to split this plant right as carefully as I can. I don't know if you can see this. I'm just going to split it open. Let's see if I can find him. Haven't found him yet. I mean, I can see where it's completely open inside the plant, where you can tell he's been. Now, a lot of times you can still save your plant if you can actually find that worm in there. After you get him out, you can squish the plant back together and put some dirt on it, and sometimes it'll regrow some roots. Oh, I see him. Oh, I see him. Here he is. See him in there? See him? He's moving around. You see him? Okay, there he is. Eating up on my squash. Now, one of the ways that you can keep this from happening is wait until about July to plant your squash, your summer squash. Or around June, take a big bucket that's yellow or a plate or something that's yellow and try to attract the actual moth, to kill the moth before they can lay the single egg on the squash that turns into him. And you can see he's still trying to eat and he's trying to hide. But we're going to have to get him out and kill him. Look, here he comes. Oh, look what he did. Did you see him? Look, he went up in through here. He's fast, too. Look at this. We can find him.
Look, it keeps going up in there. Can you see him? There he is. He's backing up now. Now, one of the good things you can do in the beginning if you do plant squash early is go ahead and put some 7 dust on them. Because the moth comes up out of the ground in June. And it flies around and looks for a plant to put the one egg on. And that egg will hatch in about a week. And this is what comes out of it. And that little boy will bore a hole into your plant, and this is what he does. He goes along the center of the plant and hollows it out, just eating away. And then after about 6 weeks, he bores a hole to come out of the plant, and he goes back into the ground, and that's where they pupate. They go through the winter time, and next summer they will come out again as an adult squash vine borer moth. Look, he's just trying. He's trying to get back in there. If you want to, you can plant a butternut squash. Those usually aren't too susceptible to the squash vine borer. Okay, so turn your head if you don't want to see me kill him. There he is. After you finish your surgery, you just want to mash the plant back together. And then we're going to cover it up with dirt. Once you put his stem back together and you cover him back up with dirt, like I've done here, you just put your pine straw over him. And then you're going to water it in. Water it in real good. I usually put about a gallon per plant and make sure it soaks down in the soil real good. And that should help your squash. But most of the time, your plant will send out some more roots and it'll heal itself over as long as you get all the little grubs out of it. Now, like I said, you need to be on the lookout for these moths around June. Put out that little yellow plate or something that'll attract them with water in it, and the moth will fall in the water. And that way you'll know to be on the lookout for them. Now, I sure do appreciate you watching, and we will see you next time here back at the garden.